In this presentation, we will be focusing on how to configure a gauge to obtain the best performance from it. The best performance from impedance track gauges can be only obtained by correct configuration. The two major steps in configuring a gauge are programming the correct chem ID and performing a learning cycle. To determine the correct chem ID, you can do a test and create a relaxed discharge relaxed log and pass these logs through the online GPC chem tool to identify a close match. If a close match is not identified, then the cells need to be sent to TI for characterization and new ID will be created for you. Once the ID has been identified and programmed, a learning cycle must be performed to learn the resistance and Qmax values and finalize the golden image. Before performing the learning cycle, make sure to enter the correct values for the following parameters: design capacity, design voltage, both of which can be found on the cell label or data sheet; charge term taper current. It is recommended that the taper current be between C over 100 and C over 10 to ensure that the battery gets properly fully charged. Discharge current threshold. This is a current threshold above which the gauge detects that it is in discharge mode. A value below C over 10 is generally reasonable. Charge current threshold. This is the current above which the gauge detects that it is in charge mode. Make sure to set this value lower than the charge term taper current. Quit current. The current below which the gauge enters relaxed mode. It is recommended that the quit current be less than C over 20 and must be less than the discharge current threshold and the charge current threshold. Term voltage, which is empty pack voltage where the gauge would ensure 0% state of charge is reported. Here is the procedure to perform a learning cycle. Discharge the battery to empty and relax for at least 5 hours. Enable IT. The update status changes from 00 to 04. Now charge the battery to full and relax for at least 2 hours. The Qmax updates at this point and the update status changes to 05. After this, completely discharge the battery to empty using a rate between C over 10 and C over 5. Resistance tables are updated during this discharge. Relax for at least 5 hours, the update status changes to 06. More details can be found in the link shown. At times, even after programming the correct chem ID and performing the learning cycle, correct gauging performance may not be obtained. We shall look into other parameters that need to be tweaked in order to obtain the best performance. Dynamic loads is one such instance where you may see the SOC dropping to zero. Possible causes are the voltage may have dropped below terminate voltage under a heavier load, or the gauge would have updated its prediction with the new heavier load and expects empty will be reached imminently. Couple of configurations that we can change for such dynamic conditions are the load mode and load select parameters. The gauge make use of this option while running simulations. We can set load mode equal to 0 for constant current simulations and load mode equal to 1 for constant power simulations. After selecting the correct load mode, it is important to pick the correct value of load select as well. Load select tells the gauge what load current or load power to assume for simulations depending on the load mode value of 0 or 1. For the load select value of 0, the simulation uses the last average run value that is stored in data memory and is typically updated after every discharge. For a value of 1, the simulation uses the running average from entire discharge. New running average will be updated in average P or I last run after discharge stops. For a value of 2, the simulation will use the present current or power as the assumed load. For a value of 3, the simulation will use a 14-second running average load. For 4, the simulation will use a fixed C over 5 rate. For 5, the simulation will use whatever value has been returned by the host to the @rate register. And finally, for 6, all simulations will use the value stored in data memory parameter userRate MA or userRate MW. Another instance where further configuration may be required is under low temperature conditions when an SOC jump to zero may be observed. The most likely cause are incorrect RB low values or incorrect thermal model parameters. To obtain the correct RB low and thermal model parameters, an RB tweak test must be performed and the data fed to the online GPC tool. Here is the RB tweak test procedure. Charge the battery at room temperature and let the battery relax for at least 2 hours. Then set the discharge temperature to 25 degrees Celsius and wait for 1 hour for the pack to reach thermal equilibrium. Discharge the battery at system typical high rate until the minimal voltage and let the battery relax for 5 hours to reach full equilibrium. Repeat all the above steps with temperature set to 0 degrees Celsius 2 hours after charging. These two data sets must be fed to the online GPC tool and the correct RB low and thermal model parameters will be obtained. Further details can be found in the link shown.